Good morning, children. Today we are going to discuss about third unit Tarot's reward. A young woodcutter named Tarot lived with his mother and father on a lonely hillside. All day long he chopped wood in the forest. Here chopped means cut into pieces. This made him sad, for he was a thoughtful son and wanted to give his old parents everything they needed. One evening, when Taro and his parents were sitting in a corner of their hut, a strong wind began to blow. It whistled through the cracks of the hut and everyone felt very cold. At that time, Taro's father said, "I wish I had a cup of sake. It would warm me and do my old heart." Here sake means a popular Japanese drink. So the Taro's father want to drink a cup of sake. This made Taro sadder than ever, for the heartwarming drink called sake was very expensive. How do I earn more money? Here expensive means costly. So that's why the Taro's thinking, how do I get more money? How do I get a little sake for my poor old father? He decided to work harder than before. Next morning, Taro jumped out of bed earlier than usual and made his way to the forest. He chopped and cut as the sun climbed. Here, climb means sunset or go. And soon he was so warm that he had to take off his jacket. His mouth was dry and his face was wet with sweat. And with that, he began to chop even faster. Thinking of the extra money he must earn to buy the sake to warm the old man's bones. Then suddenly, Taro stopped chopping. Could it be? Could it possibly be rushing water? Here, rushing water, here stream means a small river. Taro could not remember ever seeing or hearing a rushing stream in the part of the forest. He was thirsty. So the Taro was could not remember ever seeing or hearing. Hearing means listening. A rushing stream. Rushing stream means a small river. A small river sound he could not remember in the forest. So he was thirsty. The axe dropped out of his hands and he ran in the direction of the sound. Taro saw a beautiful little waterfall hidden behind a rock. Kneeling at a place where the water followed quietly, he cupped a little in his hands and put it to his lips. He tasted it again and again, and always it was a delicious sake instead of cold water. Taro quickly filled the pitcher he had with him and hurried home. Here, see the pitcher. Pitcher means pot. After only one swallow of the liquid, he stopped shivering and did a little dance in the middle of the floor. So, the Taro quickly filled the pitcher he had with him and hurried home. Hurried means fastly he went to his home, and Taro gives this delicious sake to his father. The old man was delighted with the sake. After only one swallow of the liquid, he stopped shivering and did a little dance in the middle of the floor. Taro's father politely offered her a cup of the sake. So at that time, the afternoon, a neighbor stopped by for a visit. Tara's father politely offered her a cup of the sake. The lady drank it greedily and thanked the old man. Then Taro told her the story of the magic waterfall to the neighbor lady. The lady drank it greedily and thanked the old man. Thanking them for the delicious drink, she left in a hurry. By nightfall, she had spread the story throughout the whole village. That evening, there was a long procession of visitors to the woodcutter's house. Each man heard the story of the waterfall and took a sip of the sake. In less than an hour, the pitcher was empty. Next morning, Taro started for work even earlier than the morning before. He carried with him the largest pitcher he owned for the intended first of all to go to the waterfall. When he reached it, he found to his great surprise all his neighbors there. There were carrying pitchers, jars, buckets, anything they could find to hold the magic sake. Then one villager knelt and held his mouth under the waterfall to drink. He drank again and again and then shouted angrily, "Water, nothing but water." Others also tried, but there was no sake, only cold water. "When we have been tricked," shouted the villagers. The taro was absurd. "When is taro? Let us drown him in this waterfall." When he saw how things were going, he was nowhere to be found. Muttering their anger and disappointment, the villagers left the place one by one. Taro came out from his hiding place. Was it true? He wondered. Was the sake a dream? Once more, he caught a little liquid in his hand and put it to his lips. It was the same fine sake. It was the same fine sake to their thoughtful son. The magic waterfall gave the delicious sake to him. To everyone else, it gave only cold water. So the magic waterfall gave sake to the taros. To everyone else, it gave only cold water. The story was a taro and his magic waterfall reached the emperor of Japan. He sent for the young woodcutter and rewarded him with 20 pieces of gold for having been so good and kind. Then he named the most beautiful fountain in the city after Taro. This, said the emperor, was to encourage all children to honor and obey their parents.